Arkadaşlar merhaba. Bugün 9 Mayıs Cumartesi Gulfstream Park Hipodromu'nda koşulacak olan 9 koşuluk bir programla karşınızdayım. İlk koşu 1600 metre çim pisti 3 ve yukarı yaşlara mahsus bir maiden satış koşusu. Burada ilk yer vermek istediğim isim 9 Nisan'da bu hipodromda 1600 metre çim pistteki son startında ikinci olan isim Tyler Caffaroni ile start alacak olan Maito. Daha sonra 5 numaralı Jack Beanstalk var. 26 Nisan'da bu hipodromda ne yapmış? 1700 metre kum pistteki son startında boyun farkıyla 3. olan bir isim. Daha sonra burada 10 numaralı Sweet Giant var. Sweet Giant da 9 Nisan'da bu hipodromda aynı pist ve mesafedeki son startında 2. olan bir isim. Bu koşuda yine aynı koşuda 3. olan 9 numaralı Traffic Trouble, burada yer vermek istediğim son isim Rad Ortiz Jr. ile start alıyor. Şimdi Maito'nun koşusuna bakalım. 9 Nisan'da bu hipodromda 1600 metre çim pistte ikinci oluyor. Kırmızı beyaz damalı formalı jockey ile start alan safra. Moving up on the outside and still scheming, and from between that duo reconnected, Maito is at the rail and he's now fourth. Floating very wide to the first turn as Chewy as Elite Mission floated him out to get into the clear. That's a length and a half to the team of Mountain Tree and Super Edgar, two better than Fuego. Farmstrong is nearest the inside, and Hellbent, who was usually on the lead, is last today as Rapstore walks, taking pace pressure from Elite Mission, who is a keyed up and tugging second. Now Elite Mission is on even terms with the leader, two and a half clear of We Connected third on the outside, fourth, still scheming. Maito patiently handled at this stage under Gaffleone, red colors working into the two path for clear passage, and now he's going on a mid-race move. Length and a half back to QE, who races outside of Clifton Park, then it's a gap of two to Fuego and Super Edgar. Farmstrong's in and amongst rivals, Mountain Tree nearest his inside, and the trailer is hell-bent. They went 46-4 for the opening half mile as they leave the backstretch and move on to the far turn. Rapstore rocks under siege. Elite Mission in the two paths, still scheming three wide. Chewy is in range, so is Maito, so is Clifton Park. Still many chances here, two better than an on-running Farm Strong. There's a quarter of a mile left to go. With the advantage, still scheming, who made first run and he has the lead. Toward the inside and Rapstore rocks, Maito muscles into the clear. Chewy and Clifton Park are next with an eighth of a mile to go. Still scheming, now on top by 2.5. From the outside, Chewy, from the inside, Maito. Still scheming, is almost home. He's 8-1 and he's clear. It's still scheming, who made first run to win it under Misael Jaramillo.
Koşuda ikinci oluyor. 10 numaralı Sweet Giant'ın koşusu. Bu koşuda da 10 numarayla start almış. Sarı formalı jockey ile start almış. Racing at Gulfstream. The favorite Jack Beanstalk away quickly from the center, moving to challenges. Honor this. Keep marching away in the top flight. Mr. Noisy is next. On the far outside goes Pump Room. Saving ground and marching through down toward the inside is Traffic Trouble. He's the gray, trying to secure some racing room. In tight toward the inside is Magical Mike, but he cut the corner nicely and he's into the top flight. Very wide on that first turn was Pump Room. Koşu 1600 metre için pistte 3 kare yaşlarım mahsus bir maiden satış koşusu. Marching forward on the outside, Noble Nebraskan is four wide. Three wide and keep marching in the two path honor this. From behind the speed is Magical Mike. Next to him is Traffic Trouble. Three wide and Sweet Giant. Four wide, Mr. Noisy. Two back to Skyline View. Then it's a length and a half time. A Coleman outside in Pump Room. And the trailer is making a legacy. They go half a mile from the finish. They went 46-4 for the opening half mile. It's still Jack Beanstalk to target. Jack Beanstalk into the far turn on top of half a length. Noble Nebraskan. Three wide and moving to challenge. Keep marching is between horses. On from fourth and Sweet Giant. He's in range. Trying to run home from the back is a wide running Traffic Trouble. Sliding through inside and Magical Mike's got a shot as he's going to follow Sweet Giant, who's up to challenge Jack Beanstalk. Many chances here as they turn for home. Three quarters, 1:10-4, less than a quarter of a mile to go. With the advantage now, it's Sweet Giant who comes away with the lead into the clear. Magical Mike now produced for a late effort. Magical Mike trying to get this leader, Sweet Giant. Sweet Giant almost home. Magical Mike's going to get him. Magical Mike on the major
class. Sweet Giant, Sweet Giant.
Geldik ikinci koşuya. İkinci koşu 2 yaş yeterlere mahsus bir maiden koşu. 9 metre kumpiste start alacak. Çoğu ilk kez koşuyor arkadaşlar. Burada öne çıkan isim 4 numaralı Breakthrough. Tyler Gaffalo ile start alacak olan bir isim ve 4 Mayıs'ta 600 metre için pistteki son idmanında 36-30 derece yapan bir isim. Nyquist yavrusu Breakthrough. Daha sonra Accuracy 5 numaralı Ziggy ile start alacak olan ve 6 Mayıs'ta 600 metre kum pistteki son idmanında 36-40 derece yapan 6 numaralı Cobb var. Koşudan çıkan at olursa koşma şansı bulabilecek olan Accuracy Pepe bir kere start almış. Accuracy Pepe ile start alacak olan ve 29 Nisan'da 600 metre kum pistte son idmanında 36-11 derece yapan Full Sand Cajun Breeze yavrusu Mikko Vasquez ile start alacak. Daha sonra Hyper Focus var. Irat Ortiz Junior ile start alacak olan Todd Pletcher'ın antrenesindeki bir isim. Son olarak da burada 2 numara Luis Saez ile start alacak olan Restored Order var. Yer vermek istediğim son tay olarak. Geldik 3. koşuya. 3. koşuda Todd Pletcher antrenesindeki 12 numaralı Catley de öne çıkıyor. Erat Ortiz Junior ile start alacak. Ve 11 numaralı Duracure var. Chris Landeros ile start alacak olan 11 numaralı Duracure. Todd Pletcher antrenesindeki diğer bir isim olan 5 numaralı Kahiko. Bir de son olarak burada 17 Nisan'da aynı pist ve mesafedeki son startında ikinci olan Coach de Bo şans yer vermek istediğim son isim. Şimdi Cat Lady'nin 12 numaralı Cat Lady'nin bir önceki koşu 23 Nisan'daki 23 Şubat'taki ikinci olduğu koşusunu izleyelim.
Duchess of Sussex and Paco to the outside. Track is fast. Turf is firm.
Koşu 1600 metre için 3 yaşlı dişlere mahsus bir maiden koşu. 11 numaralı sarı kep lacivert formayla start alan Safkan.
Good start for Lababia from the center of the course who reaches out for early control. Moving up on the far outside, that's Duchess of Sussex up into the top flight. Flight fit or fly, flight win is in tight, very tight in fact, as Wicked Mercury is next. And that didn't do Cat Lady any favors or Duracure. Cat Lady out in its sixth path around that first turn. As they try to settle and fly, fight, win is fighting badly. Just banged into Duracure now. Saving ground at the inside is Tis a Pity as they're really slowing down the pace. Length and a half in front of Heavenly Peace, then Midnight Marvel. And the trailer is Ballymore Star. To the backstretch they go. Lababia leads by half a length. On the outside, Duchess of Sussex is there second. From third, that's the troublemaker. Fly, fight, win. Now racing a length off the lead for Castellano with Cat Lady on the outside of her.
Bu koşuda Grant Ortiz de start almış. Bugünkü koşuda da aynı jockey ile start alacak.
Midnight Marvel, Heavenly Peace is with her and the trailer is Ballymore Star. They leave the backstretch and move on to the far turn through a 48-3 half mile. It's Lababia who continues to lead. On the outside, Duchess of Sussex is there second. Cat Lady is third, being asked to quicken with 2 lengths to make up. Wicked Mercury is next. Nothing running on significantly from the back as these top three continue to get away. Quarter of a mile from home, it's Duchess of Sussex who comes away with a narrow lead. Lababia cuts the corner and fights back second. Cat Lady in with a shot down the stand side. There's an eighth of a mile to go. Duchess of Sussex and Lababia continue to battle. Cat Lady tries to lift when it matters. 16th to go. Duchess of Sussex almost home. Cat Lady surging but out of time. Duchess of Sussex wins. Cat Lady is second. Lababia.
Geldik dördüncü koşuya günün. 1600 metre çim pistte bugüne kadar 3 yarış kazanamamış, 3 ve yukarı yaşlı dişlere mahsus bir koşu, satış koşusu. Burada arkadaşlar ilk öne çıkan MCL Janamilio ile start alacak olan Algo Donald. Birazdan yarışını izleyeceğiz. Süratli bir isim. İç kulvardan çıkma avantajını da iyi kullanırsa MCL Janamilio ile koşuyu kazanır gibi düşünüyorum. Daha sonra burada 6 numaralı Sandrift var. Tyler Gaffalone ile start alacak olan son 6 koşusunu ilk 3'te tamamlamış bir isim. Daha sonra 4 numaralı Too Much War var. O Seyaz'da start alacak olan ve 26 Mart'ta bu hipodromda aynı pist ve mesafedeki son startını kazanan, bunun da videosu var. Birazdan izleyeceğiz. 10 numaralı Get Rewarded, Hector Berrios'ta start alacak olan, bu isimde 10 Nisan'daki bu hipodromdaki 1600 metre çim pistteki son startını kazanan bir isim. Burada yer vermek istediğim bir isim daha var. Bir 2 numaralı Grace, Dana Grace, Edgar Zayas'ta start alacak olan, son startında aynı pist ve mesafede ikinci olan bir isim. Arkadaşlar, burada bir de koşudan çıkan at olursa koşma şansı bulacak olan Future Creature'la Jost Sayın var. Bunları da dikkate almanız gerekir eğer koşu kuma alınırsa. Şimdi bir numaralı Algo Donal'ın 10 Nisan'daki son koşusunu izliyoruz. Üçüncü olduğu son koşusu. Algo Donal kırmızı beyaz formalı bir numaralı safkan. İç kulvardaki
kırık. Far outside, Teacher Drama made the start today, and she's into the top flight. Gorgeous and Gray is off the speed alongside Algo Donal. Her two and a half clear is so charming. The two at the back, Janet B, does it all, and Fantastic Kingdom. In the charge around the first turn, it's Feature Creature who works over to the rail and leads a length and a half. Pocket wants the two path for Lion Condicional from second. Teacher Drama and a big number is now third. Algo Donal races from
fourth. Feature Creature da Gorgeous and Gray. Koşta koşta falan. And altı numaralı en önde giden
top flight runners. The two at the back remain Janet B does it all and Fantastic Kingdom. 5/8 left to run. Feature Creature and Luis Saez.
Yani koşu kuma alırsa koşu kuran isimlerden birisi.
On the outside, Teacher Drama is a joint second alongside in Lion Condicional third. Gorgeous and Gray is in the two path fourth with Algo Donal next at the rail. They're followed by Janet B does it all, who moves outside of So Charming, and the trailer is Fantastic Kingdom. Around the far turn they go. They went 47-2 for a half mile. Feature Creature has the lead, but Lot in Condicional on the move now and up to challenge from second. Algo Donal looks for racing room toward the rail third. The rest not picking up their feet yet, although Fantastic Kingdom tries to slide through inside. Off the turn in the stretch drive, La in Condicional tripped out nicely and she's up for the lead. Feature Creature is trying to hang on for second. Algo Donal is next. So Charming for a slice as they come home for the wire. It's 7-5 on La in Condicional. She's a four-length winner. Feature Creature second. Algo Donal was third.
Algo Donal'ın 3. olduğu koşuyu seyrettik. Şimdi Too Much War var. Bu koşuda 4 numaralı safkan. Yani bizim bugünkü koşuda. Bu koşuda da 8 numaralı yeşil formayla start alan safkan. Koşu 1600 için 4 ve yukarı yaşlara mahsus, dişlere mahsus bir satış koşusu arkadaşlar. 8 numaralı yeşil formalı safkan.
These two race on from Rooney, and after a slow getaway, here's Rosa Star moving up. Rosa Star will land second as Karenina's mid-flight. Rooney's to her inside, a length and a half better than Tell Me Mo. Then it's Garota, and at the back is Cassidy's Smile. In the charge around the first turn, the advantage to Too Much War, who leads a length and a half. Rosa Star on the outside now, second, back to third, Alita Pio. Tugging while fourth is Joss Sayin. On her outside goes Karenina. And it's a length and a half to Rooney, followed by Tell Me Mo. Garota's at the back alongside Cassidy Smiles, separated by seven lengths in the run 5 furlongs from home. Too Much War has the lead at 5-1, leads 3/4 of a length. Rosa Star on the outside is second. Alita Peel is a tripped out third. Karenin is in the two path while fourth, followed fifth by Just Sayin, securing the rail position for Rosario about 4 lengths behind. A gap of 2 to Tell Me Mo, then it's back to Rooney. Outside of her and racing second last is Garota, and trailing the field is Cassidy Smile. Around the far turn they go. Too Much War bids to make all. Leads by half a length. 3 wide in Karenina. Alita Peel looks loaded, but no place to prove it. At the inside and trying to run home again is Rosa Star. Just Sayin is going to tip 4 or 5 deep for a run as they're at the top of the stretch. Too Much War comes away with the lead. Alita Peel is loose and trying to charge while second. Just Sayin down the center of the racetrack with Karenina. 1/8 of a mile left to go. Too Much War still the target. Just Saying lunging from between Elite Appeal. Almost home, Too Much War. Just Saying surges on the outside. Here's the line, Too Much War.
Too Much War kazanıyor. 1.35 onluk derecesiyle bu koşuyu. Geldik 5. koşuya arkadaşlar. 5. koşuda 1200 metre kum pistine icra edecek olan bir yarış. Burada 3 numaralı Poseidon's Princess var. İlk kez start alıyor kariyerinde Luis Sainz ile. İlk tuttuğum isim Poseidon Princess. Sonra 5 numaralı Cape Line var. Kariyerinde 2 kez koşmuş. İkisi de çim pistte. Kum pisti ilk kez deneyecek. Dylan Davis'te start alacak olan bir isim. Daha sonra burada 1 numaralı Social Astray var. 26 Nisan'da bu hipodromda aynı pist ve mesafedeki son startında 3. olan bir isim. Son olarak da burada 10 numaralı Impression Given var. Luis Reyes ile start alacak olan son yer vermek istediğim safkan. Bu koşuyla ilgili video yok arkadaşlar. Geliyoruz 6. koşuya. 6. koşu 1600 çim maiden satış koşusu. 3 yaşlara mahsus bir koşu. Burada ilk yer vermek istediğim isimler 11 ve 12 numaralı safkanlar. Şöyle ki start aldıkları son koşuda 17 Nisan'da Reconvene 3. oluyor. Eagles Place 4. oluyor. Bu isimler öne çıkıyor. Emise Acala Miller ve Joel Rosario ile start alacak olan ilk yer vermek istediğim iki tay bunlar. Daha sonra 4 numaralı Riggins var. Brad Ortiz Jr. ile start alacak olan kariyerinin ikinci startını alacak bir isim Riggins. Son olarak da burada 8 numaralı Strong Headed var. 9 Nisan'da bu hipodromdaki son startında 1600 metre çimde ikinci olan bir isim. Şimdi burada 2 tane videomuz var. Bir tanesi Rekan Wayne'in 3. Eagle Place'in 4. olduğu yarışlar. Reconvene 6 numaralı mor formalı safkan. Eagles Place'de 9 numaralı açık mavi formalı jockey ile start alan safkan. Reconvene 6 numaralı mor forma. And the charge around the first turn. At the rail goes Reconvene as this leader is loose up front, King of Rock, followed in at the rail by Port Hunter. Sliding through inside is Chocolate Bar just behind Bourbon Wisdom and Alpha Dog. Yani koşuda dördüncü olacak. 9 numaralı açık mavi formayla start alan. Not sure it's that quick. If it is, it's trouble for King of Rock as he's going aggressively early. He's open 5 on conformity and reconvened second and third. Maverick Kitten is closer than usual. He's now 4th. Back to 5th inside goes Port Hunter. Cowtown's on a mid-race move trying to secure the rail. Just ahead of him is Eagles Palace. Wide on the course and Bourbon Wisdom. Back from there it's Chocolate Bar. Magic Street is wide. In between runners and Alpha Dog. And You Can't Catch Curlin is now last of all. They start to take much closer order now through a 45 and 1 posted half mile. King of Rock is on the ropes. Reconvene is the first to bid. Now on the outside, here's a move from Bourbon Wisdom, Cowtown's Hunting Racing Room. Right with him and Port Hunter with Maverick Kitten. Who do you like here? After 3/4 and 1:10 and 1, they turn for home with the advantage. Reconvene. He comes off the turn with the lead. Bourbon Wisdom to the attack now. Second, Maverick Kitten to no place to go. Third, Beagle's Palace is next. And Cowtown Chocolate Bar, they're all lifting late. They're trying to get this leader Reconvene. Here comes Cowtown. Reconvene 3. oluyor. Eagle Place 4. oluyor bu koşuda. Geldik 7. koşuya. 7. koşu 1000 metre çim pistte 3 yaşlı dişlere mahsus bir şartlı koşu. Burada arkadaşlar ilk öne çıkan isim 10 numaralı Compensate. Koşu performansına bakacak olursak 21 Mart'ta bu hipodromda aynı pist ve mesafedeki son startında Stakes Black Type koşuda, Melody of Colors isimli koşuda ikinci olan bir isim. Luis Saez ile start alacak. İlk tuttuğum Die ve aynı koşuda üçüncü olan Foolish Home şurada görüyorsunuz. Compensate'in ikinci olduğu Stakes koşuda üçüncü olan Foolish Humor var 5 numaralı. Bu aynı zamanda geçen sene 4 Ağustos'ta start aldığı Colin Stakes Black Type koşuyu kazanan bir isim. Foolish Humor, Brad Ortiz Jr.'a start alacak. Son olarak da burada yine kariyeri boyuncaki bu 5 startın ikisinde arkadaşlar Black Type ve Listed koşu kazanmışlığı olan bir isim. Şu Black Type koşusu, bir önceki koşusu Eylül ayındaki, öbürü de 6 Temmuz'daki My Dear Steak Listed koşu kazanmışlığı var. Son idmanında da görüyorsunuz 3 Mayıs'ta 600 metre kum pistte son idmanda 35-80 derece yapan bir isim Feskin. Bu koşuda yer vermek istediğim son type. Şimdi burada Compensate'in ikinci olduğu 21 Mart'taki ve Foolish Humor'un üçüncü olduğu aynı koşuyu izliyoruz.
Free the base coming up. Going in. We're set for a start.
Bir yanlışlık oldu galiba, bir saniye.
Marcus Manessas drawing outside to complete the line.
Pardon arkadaşlar. Evet, bu koşu.
Going in. We're set for a start. And they're off in the melody of color stakes. Hear my prayer, one of the first in to stride, the other favorite.
Compensate bu koşuda 2 numaralı mavi formayla, mavi formalı jokeyle start alan safkan ikinci olacak koşuda. Diğer yer alan safkan da 7 numaralı Foolish Humor, beyaz kep, mavi beyaz formalı jokeyle start alan safkan. Right up alongside now, second, Jess Smokin is third, Compensate tries to rally for Prado, fourth and down inside. Hemen dışındaki de beyaz kep, mavi beyaz formalı Compensate. Pardon, mavi formalı. Compensate ikinci olacak arkadaşlar. Foolish Humor üçüncü olacak. Stakes koşu. To catch Hear My Prayer, who wins the melody of colors. Second is Compensate Foolish. Geldik 8. koşuya. 8. koşu kariyerlerinde iki yarış kazanamamış yukarı yaşlılara mahsup bir koşu. Burada iki tane isim önereceğim. Birisi Brad Ortiz ile start alan Louis Kingdom. Diğeri de 8 numaralı Reservation'ıydı. Louis Sayez ile start alacak. Bu iki isim buraya yeterli gibi geliyor. Geldik son koşuya, 9. koşuya. 9. koşu bir stakes koşu. Burada ilk öne çıkan 1700 metre çim pistte bir koşu. 4 ve yukarı yaşlara mahsus. Burada arkadaşlar ilk öne çıkan isim 9 numaralı Social Paranoia. Geçen sene Temmuz ayında start aldı. Belmont Derby grup 1 koşuda ikinci olan bir isim. Daha sonra Eylül ayında geçen sene start aldı. Listed koşuyu ve bu sene 28 Mart'ta 1600 metre çim pistte start aldığı son yarışındaki Appalachian Stakes grup 3 koşuyu kazanan bir isim Social Paranoia. Bunun 28 Mart'ta bu hipodromdaki kazandığı Appalachian Stakes koşusunu izleyeceğiz birazdan. Bir diğer yer vermek istediğim isim 11 numaralı Admission Office. Admission Office de 29 Şubat'ta bu hipodromda 2200 metre çim pistteki son startında bu da bir stakes koşu, grup 2 koşu, Mac Diarmida koşusunda ikinci olan bir isim. Bunun da yarışını izleyeceğiz. Burada daha sonra 12 numaralı War of Will var. Tyler Gaffaloni'nin start alacak olan bir isim. Bu da arkadaşlar geçen sene Mayıs ayında start aldığı Preakness Preakness Stakes koşusunda grup 1 koşuyu kazanmış bir isim. War of Will, Warfront yavrusu. Burada yer vermek istediğim diğer bir isim 6 numaralı Holiday. Luis Saez'e start alacak olan. Bunun koşu performansına baktığımızda geçen sene 28 Aralık'ta start aldı. Tropical Park Derby Listed koşuyu kazanmış. Bu sene de 8 Şubat'ta 1700 metre mesafedeki Chimpis'teki Tampa Bay Stakes Grup 3 koşuda 4. olan bir isim. Warfront, diğer bir Warfront yavrusu bu da. Holiday. Bu ayakta 9. koşuda son yer vermek istediğim safkan. Şimdi gelelim Social Paranoia'nın kazandığı koşu. Stakes koşu 1600 metre için pistte 28 Mart'ta bu hipodromda yapılan bir grup 3 koşu.
And they're off in the 68th running of the Appleton. Dr. Edgar was away quickly from the center and he's going to try to get a clear advantage but Balarox and March to the
7 numaralı formayla alan jockey.
Murad is between horses. El Tormenta trying to work over, but it looks like he'll be at least 5 wide on the course. Just behind him is Smart Remark. And it's a length and a half back to English B. And El Tormenta was spun about 5 or 6 deep. Down at the inside goes Hembry third last. Louder Than Bombs is second last. And the trailer is Social Paranoia. Around the first turn they go with the advantage. Dr. Edgar and Paco in front by a neck. Murad is there second. El
Tormenta has no choice to get him forward
to try to get over to the inside. And here's El Tormenta on a backstretch blitz to put a neck on top. From between horses, Murad is there second. Down at the inside, Dr. Edgar third. These three going aggressively with Sombaye racing three wide while fourth. In between horses, Balarox down at the inside and March to the arch. Then it's a length and a half to Mr. Dumas. English B is at the inside in the black colors. Two better than Smart Remark and Hembry. Louder Than Bombs is now three wide and still at the back is Social Paranoia. Around the far turn they go. Dr. Edgar gives way and Murad is in front. Now Sombaye moves three wide. Yellow Cap on the outside. Mr. Dumas four wide. Five wide and Louder Than Bombs. Many chances here. Who do you like with Murad still the target? Sombaye, Dr. Edgar back running again from last in Social Paranoia. Here comes Social Paranoia with a
full steam.
Social Paranoia.
Son hatayla koşuyu kazanan isim geliyor. Social Paranoia bu grup 3 koşuyu kazandı. Diğer ve son videomuzda Admission Office arkadaşlar. Yarışı hangisi? 29 Şubat'taki. Grup 2 koşu.
Ruby inside Morocco wins the break and he's being sent hard to try to
get a
threat of blue who comes away in second from the far outside Armistice Day.
7 numaralı siyah formalı jockey'le start alan safkan.
He's back to fifth and proving inside was Channelmaker. He's now up into fourth. These top flight runners have three lengths on Admission Office who's outside of Sadler's Joy. 2.5 clear of Pegasus Turf winner Zulu Alpha and the early trailer Nessie. They wheel in front of us for the first time. Loose up top, Morocco ensuring a lively tempo. He's up into four length lead now. A thread of blue trying to rate his own trip while racing second. Armistice Day on the outside is third. At the inside, Channelmaker follows along in fourth. Two better than Spooky Channel. Then down at the inside goes Sadler's Joy. Outside of him, an Admission Office third last. Second last and comfortable at this stage is Zulu Alpha. And still nothing from Nessie, but still a long way to go. The opening half mile in a rock solid 46-2. Morocco doing the rabbit tactics here. He's on top by five. Racing in second is a thread of blue on the outside. Armistice Day is third. Channelmaker's had a good run of it. Fourth at the inside. Followed fifth by Spooky Channel. Then Sadler's joined Admission Office. No alarm bells going off yet from Gaffleon. He's well set
on
and five in front of Nessie. They turn into the backstretch after three quarters and 1:11.3. There's now 5 furlongs left to go. Morocco's been in front from the outset. He's gone awfully quick. A thread of blue starts to creep closer second. On the outside, Armistice Day is still third. At the inside, and Channelmaker from fourth and Spooky Channel and Sadler's Joy. Admission office travels well enough. He's about 5 lengths off the lead. A length and a half in front of Zulu Alpha, who's still confidently handled. And Nessie's been last throughout as they round the far turn. Now the pace quickens, and with the lead, it's Morocco, but only on borrowed time. From the far outside, Zulu Alpha is just going to try to swoop the group here as Admission Office got first run on him. Top of the lane in the McDermott, Admission Office kicks on with Zulu Alpha over the top, loose and charging.
And şu an en önemli şapka.
Admission Office the leader. Zulu Alpha on the outside takes his shot under Gaffleon. And here's Zulu
İkinci
Alpha to
düştü.
The front. Admission Office is game, and he's trying to cling with him, but the Pegasus Turf winner is too good. Zulu Alpha wins the McDermott.
Ve bu grup 2 kuruşta ikinci oldu arkadaşlar. Admission Office. Şimdi geldik bilgisayar desteğine. İlk koşunun yorumlaması böyle. İkinci koşu. Burada arkadaşlar 5 ve 6 ekürü, 7 ve 9 ekürü, 9. Eğer bilgisayarım burada birinci vermesinin sebebi bir tane koşusunda olması yani. Sadece o, onun dışında zaten çıkan at olursa, çıkan tay olursa koşma şansı bulacak bir isim. Sizi yanıltmasın. Benim sıralamam böyle. Bilgisayarım böyle. Üçüncü koşu. Dördüncü koşu. Arkadaşlar videoları ve yorumları beğeniyorsanız lütfen kanala abone olun. 500 gibi bir rakam yakaladık. Sizlerin bu konuda desteğinizi bekliyorum. Altıncı koşu. Yedi. Sekiz. Ve günün son koşusu, bilgisayar burada War of Will'i birinci vermiş, ben Social Paranoia'yı birinci tutuyorum. Hepinize mutlu bir cumartesi günü diliyorum. Kanala abone olmayı unutmazsanız sevinirim. Hepinize iyi cumartesileri.